Do you know why banana candy tastes nothing like bananas? It's because bananas are clones. Banana candy flavor is based on the Gros Michel banana. This banana variety used to be the most popular banana exported from Central America to the US and Europe. But in the 1950s, the banana crops were decimated by a fungal disease. Growers switched to a different kind of banana, the Cavendish, which we eat today. Banana candies, however, stayed tasting like the Gros Michel. So what does that have to do with clones? The Gros Michel banana was so susceptible to fungal disease because commercial bananas are all clones. Rather than pollinating flowers and planting seeds to get new trees, which would lead to genetic diversity, commercial banana growers make new trees by planting cuttings instead. This means that all of the Gros Michel trees had the same genome and were genetic clones. So once the fungus could infect one tree, it could infect all of them. There was no genetic variation that might protect some trees and keep the crop going. Like the Gros Michel, the Cavendish that we all eat today is also a clone. But there's so much banana diversity out there in the world that there is hope if we can expand our idea of what a banana tastes like. Would you be willing to eat a new banana to save them all?
You can keep your leather items freshly polished with this sustainable hack. The production of traditional shoe polish is highly energy intensive and includes packaging and containers that can take years to break down in landfills. While bananas are biodegradable, require much less energy to produce, and are non-toxic, thus avoiding risk of soil and water pollution from the disposal of chemical-laden polishes. Simply hold onto your banana peel after you're done eating and wipe away the inside part of the peel on any old scuffed or dusty leather item, and then remove any residue with a dry cloth. The natural oils and potassium soak into the leather and rejuvenate life in the material, giving you an all-natural organic polisher. This method helps reduce the use of petroleum-based shoe polish, which is considered hazardous waste in many states, as well as contribution to the nearly 90 million barrels of petroleum produced per day. Let us know if there's another sustainable hack you'd like me to try.
Would you eat a sandwich made from banana peels that tastes like pulled pork? Let's talk about some everyday awesome food solutions. One way to make your diet more sustainable is to reduce the amount of meat you eat. But what if you want to reduce your meat intake, cut down on food waste, and also eat a pulled pork sandwich? Banana peels are not only edible, they contain things like vitamin A and antioxidants that can actually be good for your health. But they also contain a lot of cellulose, a molecule that gives plant cells their structure, but is also very hard for us to digest. So if you're going to eat them, you probably want to cook them well. They can also irritate people with a latex allergy. Keep that in mind. Start by cleaning the peels, scraping out any remaining banana, and shredding them with a fork. Rinse them, marinate them in spices like cayenne, onion powder, garlic powder, and cumin, and then cook well, adding water to keep them hydrated. You can find lots of different recipes for this online. Now add your barbecue sauce, put it on a toasted bun, and enjoy. It really does look like pulled pork. That's not bad. I mean, pretty much anything's delicious if you cover it in barbecue sauce. Give it a try and let us know. Did you know you could make a plastic bowl out of banana peels? Let's dive into the everyday awesome science of bioplastics. The term plastic just means a malleable or moldable material made up of polymers. And a polymer is a molecule made up of smaller repeating subunits called monomers, like beads on a string. When we think of plastics, we often think of materials made out of petroleum polymers. These plastics could take up to 1,000 years to break down. But you can make plastics out of biological polymers too. For example, banana peels are made up of a polymer called cellulose that helps make up a lot of the structure in plants. So we can use a blender and vinegar to break that polymer apart into its components. Then we can squeeze out all the excess liquid and shape the remaining monomers into whatever shape we want our plastic to be. Those components can then polymerize back together to make a solid. Here I have formed a small bowl. It's not pretty, but it's mine. Scientists are experimenting with lots of different materials to make bioplastics, from banana peels and food waste to sawdust or algae. What material do you think we should try making bioplastic out of?